Good evening, everybody. My name is Dr. Avishkar Zagre, and today we are going to discuss the mind of Saponaria officinalis. Saponaria officinalis comes from the Cryophyllaceae family, or the pink or the carnation family. It is derived from the Latin word sapo, which means soap. Also, it has been used in the past as a gentle soap, as a gentle cleansing agent. Now, let us study the common names. The first common name is Bouncing Betty. In the olden times, washerwomen were called as Betties. So when they used to wash clothes, there was a movement up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down. This looks like a bouncing movement. So that is why this remedy is called Bouncing Betty, because it is used to wash clothes. Also, it is called as the Lady's Wash Bowl. It is a left-sided remedy and it's a gentle soap. When I use the word gentle, it means with love and care. Also, let us see the habitat. Now, if you see this image, here you can see that Saponaria always grows at the border. You can see my mouse moving. So Saponaria always grows under hedgerows and along the shoulder of roadways, along the periphery. This is a hedgerow. In a garden, whenever you go to a garden, you always see that there are boundaries. Okay. So basically, most of the gardens in Europe and the South American countries are marked with Saponaria officinalis because it grows at the hedgerow. So there is always a left out feeling. Okay. Saponaria officinalis has a left out feeling. These personalities also want to reach at the top in the most shortest possible way. They want to take shortcuts to success. Now let's come back to the physicals. Borick says this remedy will often break up a cold. Now what is a cold? Cold is any type of person or any personality who is not recognized, who is not getting respect but cannot come out of a situation. An unrecognized and unrespected individual who cannot come out of that difficult situation. That is a cold. That is also the same feeling as stopped up feeling in the nose. Stopped up means he cannot come out of that situation. Now nose. What does the nose signify? Nose is a symbol of inquisitiveness. Whenever we tell someone, don't poke your nose in my matters. We want them to know that he or she should not ask about me in the most meddlesome way. So nose means inquisitiveness plus meddlesome behavior. Nose means not being able to give recognition. So whenever there is a disease of the nose or whenever there's a affection of the nose, it always means that he is not being given recognition. He is being held back from achieving his goals. Whenever there is a red nose also, it also means that the person is very angry. Okay. He is not getting respect. And how will he get respect now? When you don't get respect, what do? You snatch it. You take it forcefully. So obviously, Saponaria officinalis will demand respect. He will not get it naturally. So he will take it forcefully. He will demand it because he is not giving attention to his own personality. Also because he feels hurt and he feels he is not appreciated. Not even a little bit, no appreciation whatsoever. So, to get recognition, what will he do? His defense mechanism, he will utter a loud noise. Now, let me demonstrate that to you. When two people are talking in a conversation and the third person is not understanding any part of the conversation, but he wants to be a part of the conversation, what does he do? He makes a loud sound of clearing his throat. Okay? Like this. Also, you see people with a sore throat, they do this makes them feel better. Saponaria officinalis wants recognition and he does that by uttering a loud sound. So now you get the correlation between the nose and the mind symptoms, right? He's not getting recognition, so he will want recognition and he will make noise for it. Now let us go to the rubrics. Wonderful rubrics. First rubric is indifference with sleepiness. The second rubric is indifference to pain. Now, if you combine both these rubrics, only two remedies remain. One is Thuja and the second one is Saponaria officinalis. This next rubric, indifference to dying, is the kingpin of this remedy. Singular in the Materia Medica. There is no remedy which has indifference to dying, but only this remedy has it. Now, if you see, we have discussed three rubrics and all of them have a common theme of indifference. Why does Saponaria officinalis have so much of indifference? He is indifferent to pain, to death, and also he is indifferent with sleepiness. Now you remember that we discussed he does not get respect, he does not get recognition. So he will take it forcefully, and in his journey, in his quest for getting recognition and respect, he will forget all his pain. He will forget it to the highest degree. Even if he is dying, he will forget it. He will ignore it. Why? Because he wants recognition. That's the basis of his existence. So now you understand how to use the rubrics: indifference to dying, indifference to pain, and indifference with sleepiness. So what is indifference with sleepiness? He just wants to forget everything and go to sleep. That is indifference to sleepiness. Now, if you go to the physicals, you see the eye symptoms. This remedy is a beautiful remedy for glaucoma. Now, as a physiologist, let us talk about glaucoma in terms of symptoms, and also let us discuss the pathophysiology and then correlate it to the mind and how to use this remedy in the mind symptoms. So glaucoma basically has increased intraocular pressure. Okay, in medicine, you have the symptoms of patchy blind spots, you have headache, you have nausea, vomiting, and many other symptoms. So basically, these people who have glaucoma, they have unresolved traumatic situations in the past. Unresolved traumatic situations in the past. So they want to act on them, but there is no clarification. So what do? They have increased ambition. They will take the responsibility of others. Now, this is very similar to what happens when you don't get importance. What will you do? You will try to help others. But what is the motive? What is the selfish motive behind it? You want recognition. You want respect. So helping others is a compensatory mechanism for the feeling of being left out and the feeling of not being respected. So that was glaucoma of Saponaria officinalis. Also, he has a restlessness during palpitation. Also, he has sadness with sleepiness. Now, what is sadness with sleepiness? He has these feelings which we discussed. Okay, unrespected feeling. He has the unresolved, unrecognized feeling. So, but he cannot come out of it. So, what does he do? He will go to sleep. Now, going to sleep is like being indifferent. So, that is why the rubric sadness with sleepiness. Also, this remedy is a good remedy for burns of the highest degree, third degree and fourth degree. This remedy can be applied internally and externally for burns. Now, how do we study burns in term of mind? Okay, so this is a physical symptom. How do you convert it into a mind symptom? So what happens when a patient has burns? The best word which comes up is disfigurement. You cannot identify a person who has had burns after he gets burns. And third degree and fourth degree are the highest degree of burns. If you study the pathophysiology of burns, you will come to know that it involves the maximum part of the skin of the body. So there is disfigurement. There is loss of identity. You cannot identify his face. But this is the exact theme of this remedy, is that he cannot recognize himself. Now, why he can't recognize himself? Because he does not get it from outside. So disfigurement, unrespected feeling, and not getting reputation, not getting respect, and not getting not getting respect and not getting recognition. So these three things, I repeat again: not getting respect, not getting recognition, and disfigurement of one's own identity. So these are the themes of Saponaria officinalis. I hope you have understood how to prescribe Saponaria officinalis, not on the basis of only the cold and cough, or the only the headache, or the only the glaucoma, but you have to understand that this, as any other remedy in homeopathy, can be prescribed on the mind alone. For example, we have discussed so many rubrics. Indifference to dying was the kingpin. Okay, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you continue to watch our further videos. I hope you have understood the theme. Thank you so much.